The following program is brought to you in living color on CBNC, BC, BN, NNNNNN.
Hello, I'm Rudy Panucci, and you're watching Radio Free Charleston. Welcome to Radio Free Charleston. We have a great show this week with music from the Renfields and the Tom McGees. Plus, we have an incredible, terrific short docudrama by Stephen Schmidt. But first, here's a real short song by the Renfields.
When man begins to tamper with science, the machine starts running itself.
The reason we have the Renfields, or at least three-fifths of the Renfields, unplugged on the show this week is that Vincent Renfield, the leader of the band, will be the master of ceremonies at Kanawha Players Zombie Prom on April 21st. It's going to be a fun night. Zombies, they're not just for Halloween anymore. There'll be a dancing contest, a brain-eating contest. Robert Hattie from the sci-fi series Face Off, where they called him RJ for some strange reason, will be there, and Jeremy Ambler from The Walking Dead. There'll be a pre-prom makeup session, so you can turn into a zombie, and Mike Winland Studios will be providing zombie prom photos. Details will be on your screen at the website on your screen. It's going to be a fun night, and here we have the Renfields Unplugged with Ramone's Zombie Massacre on Radio Free Charleston.
So every time we come to the States from Transylvania, which by the way is a really long drive, we had to drive over many large bodies of water and many small bodies of scene kids to get here. Every time we come to the States, we start to notice that there are more and more guys wearing attack t-shirts and less people wearing leather jackets and Ramones t-shirts. And so as we were driving in today, I looked at the Fiend and I said, "Fiend, I have a simple question that just happens to be a segue into a Renfield song.
Whatever happened to Bleach Creek Bob, Poison Hot in the Green and Hop, rockin' rock and roll radio and Sheila has a punk.
Take it, Fiend.
A 1, 2, 3, 4. Whatever happened to skin tight jeans and that bugger punk rock leather jacket scene, this emo bullshit just makes my blood run cold. So hey ho, let's go to New York, zoom the dead Ramones, take them back to Transylvania and reanimate their bones. People say punk rock is dead, let's bring it back to life. Ramone Zombie Massacre tonight.
Let's go! Let's go! The head cuts, the flames! Hey, ho! Let's go! Go, go!
just won't stop. Teeny's doing the cleaning, chop, chop, chop. Johnny's reveling around the streets, eating every emo kid he sees. Too tough to die, could he just see the light? So, hey ho, let's go to New York, consume the dead Ramones, take them back. When we cramp the latest style, emo kids and hardcore trends, behold your punk rock blind. Random zombie massacre tonight. Hey ho, let's go to New York, zoom the dead Ramones, take them back to Transylvania and reanimate their bones. People say punk rock is dead, we'll bring it back to life.
Charleston. Up next on Radio Free Charleston, we have a terrific short film by Steven Schmidt. Give Up the Fuzz, A Few Words with Clarence Fuzzy Haskins, is a docudrama. It's an interview that Steven conducted with Fuzzy at a West Virginia Music Hall of Fame event, and he dramatized the events of that with such local artists and performers as Newman Jackson, Philip Washington, and Billy Hamilton, among others. A lot of great people worked on this. You should stick through the credits, make sure you read them all, because a lot of people put a lot of work into this wonderful short film. Fuzzy Haskins was a founding member of Parliament Funkadelic, and he's a native of Elkins, West Virginia. This is a great film. I am proud to, Steve allows me to present this to you. It's so good, we're gonna turn the bug down a little bit, so that it won't be too obtrusive while you're watching it. Here is Steven Schmidt's film, Give Up the Fuzz, A Few Words with Clarence Fuzzy Haskins on Radio Free Charleston.
It's time to tell the roof off the mother sucker. Direct to you from Chocolate City, may I present Parliament Funkadelic.
Have fun, enjoy what you're doing. Don't try to do nothing like me. You do what you do, just keep doing it. Keep asking questions, keep doing it. You're gonna go to tomorrow, because now, we live in the now. You ever think about that? It's always now. Everybody on this planet Earth that's breathing and living is experiencing the same moment. This moment that you and I stand in. Everybody else in the world is in this moment. It's now. That's the vehicle we ride in. I listened to country when I grew up, ran this bandwagon at night. We didn't have like your black radio station at the time. I think we come there with maybe one come on maybe right late at night, about an hour or so. You'd hear R&B music. But everything else that I listened to was country, And, you know, and we used to sing church music, hymns, gospel at home. We harmonized. You know, we just learned, we just did it. You know, no one taught us how to harmonize. I bought a three-string guitar from a guy for about $3. And I learned the E chord on it and then just learned how to, taught myself how to play. My family was moving up to New Jersey, and my older sister went along first. Then my younger sister left me and my dad here in West Virginia. And at the age of 15, my older sister come back for me and took me along with them up to New Jersey. And I met George about 1960, my last year in high school. We worked in a barbershop, and he used to do hair, that's time processing. So I started hanging out over there after school. Started, you know, befriended George. But I used to drive him around, taking, he and I were dating girls in Perth Amboy, New Jersey. I was dating a young lady, he was dating a young lady. I was singing in another group. I was singing in high school with a group. Then one of the members of parliament left chasing a girl, went to Texas someplace and quit the group. So they chose me out of my group to come and sing with them. Met George, Calvin, Grady, Ray, and the rest is history. The five of us got our first hit record in 1967, I Want to Testify, at Westbound in Detroit. Our first trip to Detroit was 1963. We went to audition, we called on the phone, talked to somebody at Motown Records, we got an audition. And we drove from New Jersey to Detroit. We made it to Motown and we ran out of gas right in front of Hitsville, USA. They offered us a four-year contract, a three-year option, but we'd have to wait our turn because they had so many acts. Smokey Robinson, Stevie Wonder, Martha the Vandellas, the Supreme. They had all these acts. What we had to do is wait our turn, so we didn't want to do that. So we turned them down and went back home. See, it wasn't no Funkadelic, it was just Parliament. When we got our contract back from Motown, from freeing up the name Parliament, we named the band, while Motown had our contract, we named the backup band that we had, we said, come up with the name Funkadelic, and we recorded it Westbound Records. So when we got the name back, we just kept the two together. So it was always called Parliament Funkadelic, two groups in one. And we got two different record deals with each group. Brother, now, oh, you got his own thing. Everybody got their own thing. Wow! At performance that we did at the Apollo Theater, and we bombed out, we only had one uniform, and it got wet.
George, what are we supposed to do with this? Shit!
So everybody, all these other groups was going to the valley, have their valet take them to Queens and go around the corner on 42nd Street, 125th Street, and get that stuff clean. We couldn't afford it. You wear that, and you know, I'm gonna wear this. And that's how it started. Hey, look, wear what you want to wear. Let's do that. So that's how Funkadelic come about, the dress part of it, kind of, like that. Five guys who had the same goal, that's the key. Everybody got to have the same goal and see the same thing, do the same thing. That's where there's no problem.
time returned.
The Funkadelic have a new album on Westbound Records. It's called
Freedom!
To find that the planet had fallen prey to the dread placebo syndrome.
Standing on the verge to get it on tonight, y'all. Are you standing on the verge to get it on?
Parliament had but one choice: to declare war. Parliament.
Just taking music as a whole, to me, it means that if you succeed in reaching a goal, once you reach a goal with your music, then it sort of opens you up.
An older sister and three young brothers, we've seen it hard, we've seen it kind of rough. But always with a smile, she was sure to try to hide the fact from us that life was really tough.
It grew on us at the same time, and just the coincidence of us coming together, you know, it was just meant to be, the way it all happened. It's amazing. And it's just been a journey, like I said, of a lot of joy, a lot of fun. We had setbacks, problems, but it was fun. It's what we wanted to do. But you just take one day at a time, having fun. Like a lot of people ask me, what do I do? Keep doing what you're doing. Have fun, enjoy what you're doing. Don't try to do nothing like me. You do what you do, just keep doing it. Keep asking questions. You're going to go to tomorrow, because now, we live in the now. The vehicle I ride in is my now. It's going to take me to my future. Then the future gonna become the past, but I'm still in the now. It's like a vehicle. You travel from here to California, you're still in the vehicle, but you're going through cities, but you're still in the vehicle. You're in your now. You're always in your now. It's always now.
Now!
You got a real type of thing.
They had the long johns with the cowboy hat, and of course, George, he was a wow.
Then, you know, 40-minute trip from Detroit, man, you know, how you can lose a bag? But, you know, the bag wasn't lost, it was there all the time. The lady told me today.
Jose, I'm never putting any of my clothes in your
suitcase. don't, yeah.
So what am I doing? I'm reaching over and grabbing what?
No, you ain't reaching over and grabbing nothing.
Y'all got to get ready.
Radio Free Charleston.
That's about it for this week's show, but we want to remind you, April 21st, here at Kanawha Players Theater, the Zombie Prom. It's going to be a fun evening. It's going to be a party. People are dying to go to this thing. Anyway, at midnight, these doors will open, and the undead will spill out onto Washington Street, where they will lurch down to the empty glass. It'll be a special show with Hellbound Honky Tonk, Foz Rotten, and the Charlie Anteater, and the Tom McGees. But that's not all. The Tom McGees are also playing at the Pork Chop 3D Trailer Release Party on April 26th. And on May 4th, they're hosting a benefit so they can record their first album. And that's why, on the way out, we have the Tom McGees with Be Smart. Radio Free Charleston. That's it for me. I got stuff to do.
Anyway, this is Matt. Thanks, man. I wrote about a very special lady named Georgia.
That's my mom. That's my mom. Give it up for my mom.
Yeah, give it up for his mom. It's real danceable. I want to see you shaking your asses.
Radio Free Charleston is brought to you by General Substances. If it's composed of matter, we have a hand or two in it.
Hello, I'm Rudy Benucci, and you're watching Radio Free Charleston.